Hey guys, Dr. Berg here. Listen, I want to talk about what I would do if I had MS, multiple sclerosis. First of all, what is it? It's really a dysfunction of myelin. Myelin is that outer covering, that sheath, that fat layer around the nervous system. It's kind of like an insulator of a wire, okay? And that thing, you're losing that, and then you're getting all sorts of neurological issues. What's interesting is it follows the same process as atherosclerosis, which is basically hardening of the arteries, because the word sclerosis comes from the Greek word which means hardening, okay? So it's the same process. There's theories out there that it's coming from an infection, a microbe, or it's genetic, but they don't know. My thought, it's a dysfunction in the lipids, because the production of myelin is very connected with the production of cholesterol. It takes cholesterol to make myelin. And also the synapses that communicate together in the brain and the nervous system are very dependent on cholesterol. So there must be some type of dysfunction with cholesterol. Well, there is. In some of the other videos, I talk about the origin of what causes hardening of the arteries. I'll put a link down below, but personally, I think it's the exact same thing that's happening in the brain. Let's take a look at the first thing that happens. You have a lesion or some type of ulcer, and then you get this inflammatory process. Along with that comes a white blood cell immune type connection. So you have white blood cells, you have inflammation. The body's then going to bring plaque to the area. Now plaque is mainly collagen and it's like fibrous tissue. Then comes cholesterol. And all that's trying to do is trying to heal something. So the interesting thing is, like, what is behind this whole process from the origin? What's the cause of it? Well, if we look at, okay, you're losing myelin, there's an impaired glucose to the brain. So there's the glucose is not going in the brain. That's a common denominator. And there's nearly always insulin resistance, which happens to degrade and break down myelin. So really, I think from the obvious things that we talked about, it's really a problem with insulin. So we have high insulin. Now, you could have high cortisol from stress that can actually cause high insulin. And that's probably another deeper cause, because there is antibodies connected to this as well. And that's usually adrenal. But we have a situation, we have high insulin, inflammation, and plaquing. And so now, what would I do if I had this condition? I would instantly do the ketogenic diet. Why? Because that would feed the body ketones as fuel, that would feed the brain ketones, and it would create such a relief on this whole starvation of glucose that your brain would start coming alive. Now, I've checked, if you look at the relationship between MS and ketogenic diets, there's a lot of studies done with significant improvement. So if we can cut down the inflammation in the brain by running the body on ketones and no longer on sugar, because sugar creates inflammation, and we can fix insulin resistance, we can drop the inflammation down and greatly improve the brain function. So there's studies down there. There's also a link on what to eat on the ketosis diet, but that's what I would do if I had this condition. Put your comments down below. Hi guys, hey listen, I created a pretty amazing evaluation quiz down below that actually analyzes your symptoms to find the cause, the root cause of all of your symptoms, the most likely cause. So take the quiz now and we'll send you a report.